counter. Okay, see counter. When we see that or when we say that it is a counter. Counter it is nothing but in general which is used for the counting purpose. Now in the counter, basically counter is nothing but a type of the register. This is the type of the register, and these registers are nothing but a number of flip-flops containing the registers. That's why for the counting purpose we are using the different type of the counters, but all these are in the binary form. All these are in the binary form of the counters. Now this is nothing but a n bit of the registers. N bit of registers, and already we know what is a register. Registers, it is nothing but a n number of the flip flops. N number of the flip flops. Now we are having, for this first we will see regarding the binary counter. Binary counter. As binary, it is nothing but a which indicates only the form of 0 and 1s. When there is a clock pulse arrived at the input of the shift register or the flip flop, at that time, for to count the number of arrival of incoming clock pulses. Number of arrival of clock pulses in the register. To count the number of clock pulses arrived at its input is nothing but a counter. That is the function of the counter. Now, whatever the clock pulses are there, all these are in the external. External clock pulses are given to the counter or given to the shift register. Now, we are having the two types. This is the logical symbol for the counter. As we consider, it is a n bit of the counter. N bit counter. This is the clock pulse. Clock, and we are having the different output. All these are the outputs. N number of outputs. Now, and this is the flip flop we are giving here, as it is a figure 8 of positive edge trigger flip flop. Positive trigger flip flop or the counter. Positive trigger counter. Now, under type of the counter, it is where it is a negative clock pulse. N bit counter. Same clock pulse is higher, but it is showing by the bubble. It is nothing but a clock pulse when negative edge is triggered. At that time, at the negative edge, there is a triggering of the counter, and that's why this trigger. It is nothing but a B figure for the negative triggered flip flop. When negative clock pulse is there, at that time only it will be counted the pulse. This is the positive edge trigger counter or the negative clock pulse counter. These are the logical symbol for the counter. Positive edge and the negative edge. When the clock pulse is applied to the counter, at that time it will count the number of clock pulses are there. How many clock pulses are there? Depending upon the number, how much count it will be counted by the counter, it shown down. Now we will see the. This is regarding the n bit of the counter. Now, next we will see how we can define the counter, n bit binary counter. How we can calculate n bit finally found it. In the elementary binary counter, how many states are there and how many counts are there? To find out the count of that counter, we are having, for example, we will take the example as it is a 2-bit counter. 2-bit counter. 2-bit counter. It is nothing but how many bits can be count. It will be count the 2 bits. That's why it is a 2-bit counter. And 2^n, it is nothing but 2^2 is equal to 4 states. 4 states are for this counter. It is a 2-bit counter and 4 states. How many, which are the 4 states? As it is a 00, 01, 10. These are the 4 states for this 2-bit counter. For example, we will take the another example as this is the example number 2nd, 1st and 2nd. If it is a 3-bit counter, if it is a 3-bit counter, for example, for this we are having n is equal to 3. That is nothing but this 3 is a count for the bits. And 2^3 is equal to, as 2^n is equal to 2^3, because value of n is in 3. That's why 2^3 is a 8 states. How many states are there in the 3-bit counter? As we are having the 8 states for the counter. Okay. Now, next we will see the types of the counters. Types of the counters. We are having the types of the counter as first type, it is a synchronous counter. Synchronous counter. And another type of the counter, it is a asynchronous counter. Basically, in the digital electronics, as per counter, we are having the main two types, synchronous counter and the asynchronous counter. Okay, we will see the detail about the synchronous counter and the asynchronous counter. This asynchronous counter also called as a ripple counter. Ripple counter. Asynchronous, it is nothing but a ripple counter also. Now, we will see the details about the asynchronous and the synchronous counter. First, we will go for the synchronous counter. What is a synchronous counter? What is synchronous counter? When counter is clocked such that each flip-flop in the counter is triggered at the same time. When there is a triggering, with respect to triggering of each flip-flop is at the same time. At the time when there is a triggering by the clock pulse of a counter, at that time all the clock pulses are simultaneously given to each of the flip-flops. At that time there is a triggering at that time. When there are, for example, we are having the 3-bit counter. That is nothing but for 3-bit counter we are having the 3 flip-flops. And there is a clock pulse of this, and this clock pulse, it is at a time given to each of the flip-flop. That is nothing but this clock pulse at a time given to the all these 3 flip-flops. That is nothing but the triggering of each flip-flop by this common clock pulse is at a time. That's why, as its name indicates, it is a synchronous counter. That's why it is called as the synchronous counter. There is a triggering time is same. It is one triggering time for all the flip-flops. That is nothing but a synchronous counter. Now we will see the next type of the counter. It is a asynchronous counter. This is the second type or synchronous counter, or it is also called as the ripple counter. Ripple counter. What is asynchronous counter? As it is opposite of the synchronous counter. That means whatever the clock pulse is given in this synchronous asynchronous counter, it is a one by one. For example, if we take these four flip flops as a counter, that is nothing but a 4-bit of the counter. Flip flop number 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, whatever the clock pulse it is given to this first one, it is a clock pulse, and output of this flip flop is nothing but a input to the second flip flop as a clock pulse. It is nothing but a asynchronous counter. Now, when output of the first clock pulse is given to the second flip flop as a clock pulse, now here the output of this second clock flip flop, it is given as a clock pulse to the third. Whatever the output of the third, it is given the input or clock pulse for the next one. As in this way, there is a clock pulse given. That's why it is nothing but a asynchronous counter. Okay, here that is nothing but there is a at a time clock pulse is not given in this asynchronous counter. One by one. First clock pulse is given to the first flip flop. Then whatever the output, it is nothing but a clock pulse to the second. Whatever the output of the second, nothing but a clock pulse to the third. Output of the third is nothing but a clock pulse for the fourth. In this way, there is a time requirement, propagation delay in the operation. That's why this flip flop, it is nothing but a asynchronous counter. Okay. Now we will see what that is the main difference in between the synchronous counter and the asynchronous counter. Okay? By depend on, there is a difference only by in which way we are giving the clock pulse to the counter. Now we will see the difference in between the asynchronous counter and the synchronous counter. Now see the difference between the asynchronous counter and the synchronous counter. See, this is the comparison for the counter. In the asynchronous counter, it is when there is a clock pulse is applied at the output of the first flip flop to the clock pulse as a next flip flop. But in the synchronous counter, there is no connection in between the output of the first flip flops and the input or the clock pulse for the second flip flop. There is a no connection. Now the second another difference, it is all flip flops not clocked simultaneously in the asynchronous counter, because as there is a simultaneous connection in between for output of the first and the clock pulse for the second. But in the synchronous counter, all flip flops are clocked simultaneously. Now next difference is as per the logic circuit. Whatever the logic design is there, logic circuit is very simple even for more number of states in the asynchronous. And here synchronous counter, because here we require separate clock pulse to the each counter or each flip flop, that's why there is a logic circuit design is very much complex, as there is a more number of states in the counter. And the most important bit, it is a drawback. Drawback of the asynchronous counter is that there is a slow speed or the low speed in the due to the propagation delay by using the clock pulse, or as one state giving the clock pulse to the second stage. And finally, whenever the last stage and for last stage for the clock pulses, there is a too much propagation delay in the operation. That's why the speed of this operation in the asynchronous counter is a low. But this is the advantages for the synchronous counter, as there is a high speed. because we are having at a time simultaneous clock pulse we are giving to the synchronous counter in the flip flop. That is the asynchronous counter and the synchronous counter. Mostly in the digital electronics we are using the synchronous counter because of the speed. Now the last bit from the counter, it is the modulus of counter. First we will see what is the modulus. Modulus of the counter, it is nothing but how much total number of counter can count. That is nothing but the maximum count a counter can count, or the number of stable states in that counter. That is nothing but a modulus of the counter. By using that we can find out how much stable states in that counter, or how much the capacity of the counter for the counting. It is nothing but the modulus of the counter. That's right. For example, if we consider mod 6 counter, mod 6 counter, it is nothing but a modulus 6 counter. That means the number of stable states in these are 6 states, and number of counting, it is up to the 6. That's right. Here we are having the states, or the states 0 to 5. By considering 0 to the 5, the number of states are 6. For example, we will take another example as mod 3 counter. Mod 3 counter, it is nothing but we are having the 3 stable states as from the 0 to 2. By considering 0, we are having the 3 stable states. We can draw the state diagram for the mod 10 counter. State diagram for the mod 10 counter. Now, for the mod 10 counter, we are having the states 0 to 9. That's right. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, and 9. From in this direction the counting is from the state number 4, 1 to 2, 3, 4, 5. Again from 9 to 1, it is shifted. That is nothing but this is the state diagram for the mod 10 counter. Okay? In this way we have seen in the lecture, that is a topic counter. What is the counter? Then type of the counter, positive edge type of the counter, negative edge triggered counter, types of the counter, synchronous counter, asynchronous counter, the difference of the counter, and the last that we have seen right now, it is a modulus of counter. Now today we will stop here.